Henri-Louis Pernod. The founder of a dynasty of spirits creators, Henri-Louis Pernod, ensured his name lives on in that of the empire he started over 200 years ago. Pernod was born in 1776 in Switzerland. His father was a professional distiller of absinthe, which at the time was consumed in the region solely as an elixir for its medicinal properties. However, a local businessman, Major Dubier, saw its commercial potential, bought the recipe and opened a distillery in Couvet, Switzerland. With no experience in the art of distilling, Dubier hired his son-in-law, 21-year-old Henri-Louis Pernod, to run the distillery. Pernod soon perfected the first authentic recipe for an absinthe-based spirit, combining Grand Wormwood, Petite Wormwood, Green Anise, Fennel, Melissa and Hyssop, in proportions that are kept secret even today. Pernod and Dubier's partnership lasted until Pernod, aged 29, struck out on his own and founded his distillery across the border in Pontarlier, France. The year was 1805. Pernod fils was born. In 1830, French soldiers colonizing Algeria took absinthe with them to combat dysentery, adding a few drops of it to their water ration. It came back to France with a glorious reputation as the preferred tipple of officers filling the cafes of the Grand Boulevard. Rapidly adopted by artists and the upper classes, absinthe was such a success that by the mid-19th century, its distinctive color led to the time for the pre-dinner drinks becoming known as the Green Hour. After Henri-Louis Pernod's death in 1851, first his wife, then his grandsons, Louis-Alfred and Fritz Pernod, brought the brand into the modern era. In 1878, in Pontarlier, they opened a huge state-of-the-art distillery. As the leading brand in the absinthe market, Pernod enjoyed an incomparable reputation. From raw materials to production and storage, everything was done to ensure the highest possible quality. From 16 liters per day when Henri-Louis started out, daily production grew prodigiously to 20,000 liters, part of which was exported overseas. Absinthe also benefited from the phylloxera epidemic ravaging French vineyards at the time, resulting in sharp increases in wine prices. In 1900, with Pernod at the height of its fame, cries of "Garçon, un Pernod!" could be heard wherever aperitifs were being served. More than a trend, absinthe had become a social phenomenon, aided by the mesmerizing ritual that accompanied its consumption. Icy water trickled drop by drop into a sugar cube, dissolving it and clouding the liquid spirit languishing in the bottom of the glass. Artists and creative types were crazy for the Green Fairy, as it was known. Van Gogh, Manet and Picasso celebrated it in their paintings. Toulouse-Lautrec wouldn't go anywhere without his famous walking stick containing a phial of absinthe. Poems, songs, pamphlets and plays. Pernod's absinthe inspired generations of artists. But the wine lobby frowned on the competition and exerted its considerable influence to get absinthe banned. Never hesitating to resort to misleading slogans, in alliance with the temperance movement, they demonized absinthe, accusing every brand of low quality and potentially fatal side effects. In 1915, the Parliament voted to outlaw absinthe and brought Pernod's glory days to a brutal end. Absinthe disappeared from France until the early 21st century, when the law was changed and it rose from the ashes, now called Pernod with extracts of absinthe plants, but still produced according to the handwritten recipe passed down through the generations. And it's a hint of past glories full of mystery that mingles at the bottom of the glass with the green shades and gentle aromas of the legacy of Henri-Louis Pernod.